Welcome back. In this session, we are going to understand even BW material type. The difference between NLAG and even BW, in NLAG, we are not going to maintain quantity as well as the value in MM module. That means nothing will be updated in MM module, neither quantity nor value. Coming to even BW, here quantity will be updated in MM module. No value will be updated. If you have a scenario, you want to track the inventory, not the value, then use even BW for consumables. Once quantity is updated in MM module, from there you can consume this quantity for different cost centers. At the time of consumption from this quantity, no financial posting will be generated. That we will see practically. First, go and check this OMS2. If you compare this third scenario with first and second, even though we didn't enter any storage location, system didn't throw any error message. Coming to UNBW, storage location is mandatory. Go and check OMS2. Click on position. UNBW, non-valuated material, select this, click on position, enter your plant here, 8801, select for both the plants, quantity, we are testing only for this plant, but I am selecting for both here. Now select this quantity updating, save this. Now, next step is to create a material master with reference to UNBW. Go to MM01, here retail, select this UNBW here we have, select this, now press enter. Select basics, purchasing, see the storage, plant data storage. Here you won't find any accounting tab here. Press enter. Enter your plant here, 8800, 8801. Enter storage location, 0001. Stationary master UNBW. This is EA. Select any. Press enter. Press enter. Save this. See 33 number created. Now copy this scenario, this is test case 3, material number is 33, now go to ME51N, enter here. Okay, 33 material, quantity is 10, press enter, so copy this GL, 405, enter cost center, enter valuation price, system is asking valuation price, enter 10 valuation price. Change this delivery date, check for consistency, save this. we have successfully created PR for given BW material type. Note on this. Next step is to convert PR into purchase order. ME21N. Click on document overview. Select this is recent one. Adapt. Here we need to enter vendor. Net price must be greater than zero. Price is not copied from purchase requisition. Now check for consistency. We don't have any issue here. Storage location, we didn't maintain storage location here, but at the time of receiving the goods, you need to maintain this one. See release strategy, we need to approve this. Save this. Now next step, approve this PO. ME29N. Approve this. Save. Next step, MIGO, receiving the goods. Receiving goods. Select here goods receipt against purchase order. Enter purchase order here, press enter, item is OK. Here we need to maintain storage location, that is compulsory for UNBW articles. Check here, see enter storage location. Check for consistency, positive. Now display document overview. This is FI document, stationary expenses to GRIR. Here all cost has been charged to this one only. We are interested in generally cost already expensed here. We are interested to maintain the quantity in MM module. That is the reason we selected UNBW. Now this is a material document. If you want to see this material document, you can check this from MM MB03. Press enter. See, this is the quantity, this is the plant, this is the storage location. Now go and check MMBE material report, stock report. MMBE. This is the stock overview for this material. Here execute. See, only quantity is updated. This company code, this plant, this storage location, quantity is updated. Even you can check this from warehouse report MB52. Here execute. See, this is unrestricted quantity. What is the value of this unrestricted quantity? Value is zero. We are not interested in maintaining the value. We are interested in tracking this quantity, how we are consuming this quantity. If you have a scenario like this for consumables, then you can use a UNBW material type. From here you can consume this to any cost center. Invoice verification. We will complete this step. Invoice verification. Another step. MIRO. PO number. Value 100. Select here V0. simulate four states. Successfully posted. Display following documents. This is the entry posted here. Now close this and open MyGO. Now this is the stock report. Here we have 10 quantity in unrestricted. What I will do, I will issue this to a cost center. Goods issue, here GI for cost center. What we have to do here, maintain number here, number is 33. I want to issue to from 8801 plant 0001 location. Item is okay. Now I am issuing the goods to cost center. Here account assignment you need to maintain here. This is mandatory. This time I will issue this to marketing for testing. No need for any GL account. Even you give GL account, system won't post anything since it is a non-valuated. Check, this is complete, post it, document posted. If you want to see document, display document, click on FI document. See, no subsequent document found in accounting. It is a non-valuated goods issue. Like this, you can consume this. Go and check this one. Right now we have 8 out. Right now we have 10 here before issuing the goods to cost center. Out of this we consume 2 for cost center. Balance will be 8. No value, only quantity here. Hope you understand this process. If you have a scenario like this for consumables, business is not interested in value here. They are interested for tracking. Already whatever the expenditure associated with this 10 already expensed to a cost center at the time of GR itself. Further, we are interested in tracking this inventory. That is the reason we created from UNBW. In next session, we are going to understand how to use this account assignment category U.